Tonight. Can you say amen tonight? If you're glad to be outside, if you're glad to have a live concert, they said I can't say concert, so let me say schmanfert. If you're glad to see people, say amen tonight. God is a good God. My name is Ricky Jenkins. I want to welcome you tonight. We're going to get right back into worship after a few words from some pastors to tell the story as to what we are trying to get done tonight when we say love local CV, united in community and elevating small businesses. We have put our drawn a line in the sand, and we have seen the plight of small businesses in our valley closing their doors, some forever. And it is said that in the next year that 9 out of America's 30 million businesses will close their doors forever. We have come tonight in the name of Jesus to say in the Coachella Valley, not on our watch. So when we say love local, that's what we mean. We love local. We are 15, 16 churches around the valley who have partnered with the Chamber of Commerce and leaders in our community and like-minded folks who believe that America lives and dies on small businesses. And we are here to lift them up and say, we love local. Put your hands together. So tonight is about a night of worship. We're gonna celebrate and we're going to unleash compassion on small businesses. That's why we came tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a worship team made up of worship leaders from all over the Coachella Valley. Band leaders from all over the Coachella Valley, give it up. Different pastors from around the valley united as one for the Love Local movement. So put your hands together, stay standing, because it's a party tonight. You don't sit down in no party, do you? At a party, you stand up in the name of Jesus. So put your hands together to hear the story of Love Local. Pastor Tim Cool of Southwest Church, Pastor Obed Martinez of Destiny Church, give it up as they come.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is an absolute thrill to have all of you join us on our campus. My name is Tim Cool. I'm a pastor here at Southwest.
And my name is Obed Martinez, and I'm pastor of Destiny Church.
Absolutely. And here's what I'll say. If you attend the church of one of the pastors who's on stage, disrupt us. You cheer for them. You holler. You do whatever. Yeah. And Southwesterners, if you want to hoot and holler for Destiny as well, you do that right now. So, Obed, we've got 15 churches gathered for the same cause. What does it mean to see the body of Christ across the valley unite for a movement like this?
Well, first of all, let me give honor where honor is due, and we want to honor Southwest. And I really believe Pastor Ricky and I have had multiple conversations about this. And honor is the very thing that unlocks miracles. The Bible says where Jesus wasn't honored, his miracles were limited. And so 15 churches lets us know that we honor Jesus first, and we honor the valley, and we honor business people here. So I'm ready for a night of miracles.
Okay, and so speaking of miracles and speaking of honoring churches, I mean businesses, what's our goal tonight, Pastor?
Our goal tonight is $100,000.
Yeah, it sure
That's
is.
Our goal tonight, right?
It sure is.
And there's many ways people can do it. They can give. You can text to LLCV to 94,000.
Yep.
Or you can to lovelocal.org. CV, you got it all right?
Yeah. You can send a text message to 94000.
I had it all right.
And in the body of that text, you just write LLCV. Mm-hmm. Text LLCV to the number 94000. You can hop on our website. And for those of you streaming, wherever you are, in a car, in a home, in a kitchen, you can hop on the website and give that way. Tremendously secure. For those of us who are on the lawn, can you tell everyone who's watching online hello? Can you give, there we go. For those of you who are watching here on the lawn, we also have a number of locations around our lawn. It's just a tall black box. You can drop your physical gift in there. And in a couple of songs, we're going to give you an opportunity to, man, does anybody remember old school offerings? Do you remember old school offerings?
Those are the best.
We're going to take an old school offering in a couple of songs. So all night long, you've got one night to give. We will open this up and we're shutting it back down. One night to give. Every single church that's participating is going to take a portion of what we give and bless businesses across this valley. We're all in it together.
Come on now. I'm all in it with you guys.
Okay. All right. So then we're going to keep you guys worshiping all night long, and make sure that you either text to give, hop on the website, or physical offerings as well. All right. All right. All right, Pastor Obed, I think that's everything we got. We're going to keep this moving.
Let's rock and roll.
All right.
So we're filming live, Craig Campbell from CoachellaValley.com, and just gotten their shot a little bit.
It was the truth till I just take this time to worship him. God, we thank you for your goodness. God, we thank you that you chose us, Father. And you rose us from the grave, Lord. Thank you.
Things we're going to do tonight is hear from the hearts of the pastors of the churches who are participating in this event. And part of what we'll do is hear from the hearts of the businesses who will benefit from this event. Most of our time will be spent in worship. And for those of you watching online, take these moments as you're hearing from the churches and from our businesses, maybe to give, maybe to hit that drop-down menu and for you to decide what you can do to advance the name of Christ through the people of Christ in our valley. Now, one of those churches and one of those pastors is Church 212 and Pastor Mike Harrison. Can you guys please welcome him to our stage? Pastor, you've shepherded folks for many, many years, and you've seen folks go through a lot of hard times. This was a unique year, even for you?
Yes, it was, very much so.
Yep, it sure was. We all know the different weights that set on all of us, either in business or with kids who couldn't be in school, or a lot of us had very modified church experience for a year. But what's the opportunity that sits in front of us right now, Pastor?
Well, I think the opportunity really is that we get to give back, actually, to our business people who have been giving to us all these years.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
They have been the bedrock of supporting our ministry so many years, and my wife and I have been in pastoral ministry 41 years.
Hey, can you guys give it up for that right
we've
now?
We've seen a lot of business people who have gone the extra degree, and Church 212, by the way, 212 is the extra degree, because it's the boiling point.
Yes,
and
it so is. Transformation happens at that point.
They have. Yeah. And we've seen them go the extra degree time and time and time again, year after year after year after year. And so when Pastor Ricky called us together over here in this wonderful area and said, this is our opportunity to give back, we were in.
Yeah.
And my son, Daniel, he invited me to come to the meeting because I was technically on sabbatical at the time. And he said, Dad, we got to go to this lunch. And I said, that's wonderful. I'm coming with you. And then when Pastor Ricky cast the vision to all of us as pastors, said, this is our opportunity, I said, we're in. We're so excited to be a part of this.
Amen and amen. Can I give you an update?
Please.
Okay, we're about 11 minutes into this event, and we've already raised our first $8,000, guys. About 11 minutes in, and we've got $8,000 already pledged. So thank you for those of you who are giving online. For those of you that you would love to be giving right now, not just worshiping, pull out your phones, y'all, and we're gonna walk you through it. You're going to start a text message to the phone number 94000. I know that's not a whole phone number. Don't worry. It's magic and technology. And then after you've typed in a text to 94000, in the body of the text, instead of sending a thumbs up emoji or I love local, you're going to type LLCV and send it off. And then we will send your phone a link and we'll get you started to make sure every single thing that we give tonight stays for this event. Every single dollar we give tonight is going to be moved through all 15 churches back into this valley. Every single dollar we give tonight goes to help businesses that the Chamber of Commerce and a number of churches have all helped coordinate. Your giving tonight stays right here. Yes, absolutely. One of the things that we decided that we would do is, regardless of the size of the church, everyone is walking away with the same slice of encouragement tonight. And so the role that Southwest is playing is only to host and then to move that money to all the different ministries. So if you would like to write a check tonight, we need you to write the check to Southwest Church, and we will receive that only tonight. Tomorrow morning is Sunday, y'all. Everybody's churches is receiving an offering to keep the lights on and ministry going. Everything we do tonight, we are giving away completely. So if you're passionate about this project, you need to do it tonight. checks are written, there are bugs flying so many personal places right now. I'm just, there's, hey, they don't know about
Jim,
the Rona.
You wouldn't believe this, but I had that happening to me when I was preaching.
Uh-huh.
And I did this and it went down my throat. So I felt like I needed explanation to the front row, so I said, I just swallowed that fly. Can you believe that my sons recorded that and they use it to torment me today?
Why is story time with Pastor Mike?
Don't need any flies.
Okay, I will not. We'd love to take a physical offering right now, and so what we're going to ask Ken, come on over here, hon. Get nice and close. She is in one of our shirts, and she's got buckets. We are trying to have a really fantastic event in a safe way. So if you'd like, during this next worship set, you can be giving to that. You can raise a hand. We'll get you a bucket. But we are going to take the opportunity that, Pastor, I love what you said. They've been supporting us for years. It's our turn to turn around and give it all to them. And so if you'd like to physically give tonight, either cash or a check, checkmate to Southwest Church. And I promise you, we are keeping none of it. We're sharing it with every single church who's participating, and those churches are sharing it with the Valley. So you can hit a bucket. We've got about 8 towers around our lawn. And with that said, Pastor Mike, I'm going to ask you to hand over the mic to one of our own local small businesses. Phil Cordova, you come on over here, and if you could help Pastor Mike down. Can you guys thank Pastor Mike for being with us? And then we're welcoming to the stage one of our small businesses here in the Valley. We have selected Mr. Phil Cordova because the nature of his business was tremendously impacted by the nature of the pandemic. So can you guys please welcome to the front Mr. Phil Cordova? Phil, you are your business is Cordova Photography. Tell us a little bit about what your business does and then how it was impacted by the pandemic.
Yes. So mostly the main things that we do is we photograph elementary schools, we do sports leagues, and then also corporate events. And a lot of that, pretty much all of that, was shut down because of the pandemic. And so it had a huge impact on us.
Yeah. We all had our elementary kids doing school in the kitchen and in the closet and in the living room while we were doing work in the kitchen or the closet or the living room. So the pandemic, its impact on schools had a deep impact on your business and basically just a ton of lost business.
Yeah, we were projecting to be down about 85,000, which is a pretty big number when you're a small business. So, and sometime back, Ricky had mentioned something about this event and knew my story and kind of said, you know, I want to bring you and maybe be able to help out. And I was just honored for that. You know, since then, things have changed, praise God. And
yeah.
So I'm in a situation now where, you know, whatever maybe would have come my way, go on to somebody else. And I love it, and I just thank Him every day for that.
Wonderful. One of the things that you mentioned, though, and that we talked about beforehand, is in the giant gaps created in your business, God allowed you and your passion and your life to even have another focus. What's one of the ways that God filled the gap that was created through the pandemic?
So, my heart really lives in the Mexico Loft House ministry.
Yes. Come on, that's right!
And so I've been involved with that with Hands of Mercy for quite a few years. I recently was installed as the president about a year and a half ago, and we were needing to take it from, as I say, Hands of Mercy 1.0 to 2.0. And so in that gap, we were able to spend a lot of time revamping things and restructuring. And so, you know, what I tried to focus on was remain in Him. And whatever He's called you to do, keep doing it. He'll take care of the details, but just stay focused on that, whatever He's called you to do, and that's what we did.
Phil, that is so incredible. You are the perfect story of what we can make a difference in. If you are here right now, you can text to give. You can give physically during this moment and during these songs. If you're watching online, there's one more way that you can give. And I'll just look over here at this camera. I'm not sure which number it is. One of the ways that you can give is to give us a phone call. And if you're encouraged by what we're doing tonight with 15 churches across our whole valley, give us a call at 760-200-2021. 760-200-2021. We got a team of people inside that can walk you through secure giving. Phil, thank you for being with us tonight. Can you guys thank Cordova Photography for joining us tonight? With that said, we want to keep you moving back into worship. Keep the giving going all night long. We're going to give you more and more updates. Prayer is led right now by Pastor Ruben Martinez at Christ is Salvation Church, and then back into worship. I'll see you in a few.
Amen. God is good, amen? He's an awesome God. Amen. I'm supposed to pray, but I want to say something before I pray. I had a little boy was come to my house by his dad and said that he had leukemia. And he was crying. The dad was crying. He says, I need help. My son has leukemia. And he had tears in his eyes. And he needed help. And I said, do you believe in Jesus? Would you like to receive Jesus? And he said, I will. I can do anything for my son. So I went to my house and got a little bit of juice, of grape juice. Establishing the kingdom of God, what Jesus did at the cross of Calvary for us. He took the juice, we drank the juice, they received Jesus as Lord and Savior. They confessed him, they received him, they went home. 2 weeks later, they came back. The dad said, Pastor Reuben, they made a mistake. Nothing's wrong with my son. Nothing's wrong with my son. I'm here to tell you that because of what's going on in businesses, in minds, and in hearts, and in families. The children maybe are suffering to the point of in the blood. But we have a blood that was shed at the cross of Calvary. It is that blood, the blood of Jesus, the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. It is the blood that speaks for us. It is the blood that brings life. Another gentleman came to me and says, my wife can't have children. And I said, what are you doing about it? He says, I spent already $20,000 of paying the doctors to do an insemination. And I said, I have a real doctor that doesn't charge. We pray. As we pray, his wife has 2 children now. I'm here to tell you, whatever was barren in any business, no prosperity in any business, in any family, in the name of Jesus, by the precious blood of Jesus, it is Jesus that is exalted. It is the name of Jesus that the blind can see. It is in the name of Jesus that there was going to be provision for your family, for your life, for your wife, for your marriage. It's a moment of revival. I must ask, we pray for this place in the name of Jesus. It is the blood of the Lamb. It is the blood of Jesus, the one that can bring life all over the Coachella Valley, in your house, in your heart, in your family, with your wife, with your son, with your daughter, in every business, in finances, in your mind, in the name of Jesus. Father, I'm going to ask everyone just to lift your hands before the Lord right now tonight. As we lift our hands, we establish his kingdom. What you did for us at the cross of Calvary 2,000 years ago. We don't only see the cross. We believe in what you did at the cross. It was your shed blood. For without the shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness of sins. Minds are being set free in the name of Jesus. Marriages are being blessed in the name of Jesus. Families are being blessed in the name of Jesus. Father, we are God conscious tonight. We have come because we are not pandemic conscious, and we are not financial trouble conscious, and we are not anything that is needed conscious. We have come to the one, to our Father that provides for all of us at the cross of Calvary. His name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. To him be the glory in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Blessed every mind, blessed every heart, blessed every marriage, blessed every family, every business, every heart that was hurting, that felt the need, that was dying, in the name of Jesus, life has come. The blood of Jesus be sprinkled in every business, in every home, in Jesus' name. Be blessed. Amen.
Come on, would you just lift your hands where you're at? We believe in your promises. You're so faithful, God. Nobody greater.
You are here, you're working in this place. I worship you.
Come on, one more time, say, if that is who you are. Come on, even when it looks scary.
That is who you are.
We still put our trust in you.
That is who you are. That is who you are.
Yeah.
Church, church. Put up my mic, man. Church. This is a moment that we can't let pass by. All right? We are declaring something so powerful right here that with our strength, we can't. We don't have the strength to change this valley. We don't have the strength to even change our families. But with the King of Kings, with the Lord of Lords, with the most powerful force this universe has ever experienced on our side, all of that is possible. All of that is possible. So this is what I want us to do. I want us to sing that chorus again, and I'd like you, Desiree, to come back and lead it. But as we sing it, let's raise our voices. Let's raise our hands on behalf of this valley. Let's raise our voices on behalf of the businesses in this valley. Let's raise our hands for the revival that we've been praying for in this valley. That by God's grace and by God's strength, He is a miracle worker, and He can do it. He can do it.
Truly believe that our God is a way maker and a miracle performer. Do you believe that? You know, this week I didn't feel like it, to be honest, a little bit. You know, sometimes we don't feel like it, right? Sometimes we don't see it. And that's why we can't stand on our feelings, right? We got to take our feelings, align them with our faith, and point them to the truth of God's word. Amen? We're going to sing again. And I just want to share with you for a moment. I love what we're doing tonight. My name is Daniel Harrison. That was my dad that talked a little bit ago. I'm from Church 212. I'm a worship and teaching pastor. And I really, really believe that one church can make a huge difference in the world. But I also believe that when we band together, we can make an even greater difference. And I see a lot of people here tonight, and I really do know that every one of you want to see the cities of the Coachella Valley transformed by the love of Jesus. Raise your hand if you want to see that. You know, I'm just one person. At one little church, we have like 200 people on Sundays. But you know how many people are here, actually? Just on the stage. We have 8 different churches on the stage. How cool is that? And I think about this all the time. You know, the church is a missional community, right? We're a missional community. We know that. But to be truly a missional community, first we have to be an attractional community. We have to have a mission and a message that's attractive to the lost. And I feel like the Love Local initiative and everything that we're doing tonight, I feel like this is attractive to our communities. Don't you agree? And this honors the name of Jesus. That's our theme tonight, right? And as a worship pastor, I know I'm only one up here that I was asked to share, but I think I can speak on behalf of everybody here and all the worship teams here. We want to ask you, if you will worship God tonight with your giving. Okay, we know how to worship Him with our singing. We do it all the time. But will we worship Him with our giving? Tonight, Pastor Ricky was just talking to everybody, and he said, guys, I want you to remember that people are hurting. There's a lot of businesses that are suffering, families are suffering. And you know, we're here for them. God has put breath in our lungs so that we can be a blessing to other people. And so tonight, we're going to give. But you know what? After tonight, we're going to keep giving, right? We're going to keep giving, and we're going to keep giving, and we're going to keep giving, and we're going to keep being generous, and we're going to keep being generous, and we're going to keep being generous. You know why? This is what we do. Be a blessing, for this you were called. God blessed Abraham and said, I'm blessing you so that you can be a blessing. This is who we are. We seek the peace and the prosperity of the Coachella Valley, because when it prospers, we prosper. But we have to do it together. Will you turn to your neighbor and say, together?
Together.
Well, we're going to continue worshiping tonight. We're going to worship by singing. We're going to sing a song called Great Are You, Lord. And John 6:63 says this, the flesh is of no help at all. It is the Spirit who gives life. And so as we turn our eyes to Jesus, we're going to remember that Jesus is the one who reaches down and saves us, right? He's the one that's going to transform our communities. We're not going to do anything but trust Him. Okay, so He has put breath in our lungs so that we can praise Him, but also so that we can bless other people and lead them to Jesus. So let's worship with our singing, but let's worship with our giving. Amen?
Amen.
100% of these proceeds are going to businesses in the Coachella Valley to support them, small businesses affected by the COVID, the pandemic. Hope you're enjoying the worship music tonight.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope. You restore every heart that is broken.
Let me hear your voice and see.
And great are you, Lord.
Let's get that breath back in praise.
And it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath.
So will His people, amen? Let's lift our hands to Jesus tonight. All of our praise.
All the
the voices. Come on, lift it up.
And it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise.
Come on, let's sing it a little louder.
It's your breath.
This evening for who he is and what he's done.
Psalms 22, verse 3 says, yet you are holy and you are enthroned in the praises of your people. How many of you can do a loud sound of victory tonight for what God is doing? You know why we're coming here tonight? You know why we're singing? We're singing because we believe and we serve a God of miracles. As we sang a little while ago, we believe that God can do miracles. We serve a God, the same God that opened the seas for the people of Israel, the same God that made fire come from heaven. We serve that God. And you know why we praise him? Because I don't know how you came tonight. Maybe you were broken, but now you are complete. Maybe you were sick, but now you're healed. Maybe you were discouraged, but now you are encouraged. Maybe you were defeated, but now you have the victory. And as we sing this next song, I want us to sing with that conviction and said, Lord, do it again. You can do it again. Marcel, just raise your hands wherever you are right now.
believe what you're seeking tonight. Come on, make a joyful noise. Thank you, Jesus. For you to have another seat again. We're going to spend a couple moments giving you some updates, introducing you to another church and another business. We are so thrilled to have, guys, it's hard to get two of my four kids degree on anything, and we got 8-9 different churches on our stage all killing it for worship tonight, so we can thank them. My goodness. All right, Pastor, we've got Pastor Chris Hushaw with us this evening.
Woo! Tim, I am so encouraged about tonight.
Really? Well,
I am so encouraged.
I can't imagine why you would
be. Pastor Ricky, thank you for just calling the church to be the church. Amen. This is what it's all about.
Amen. Okay, so that's exactly what I wanted to ask you about. You've been in ministry for a number of years. It's been a hard 1 year. What does encouragement do for people in a season like this?
That is a great question. You know, encouragement to me is probably the most important thing that every person needs. I mean, without encouragement, relationships fail. Without encouragement, marriages fall apart. Without encouragement, parents give up on their kids and this community falls apart. Encouragement, I think, actually is defined this way. The greatest teacher in the New Testament, the Apostle Paul, gave us three words: faith, hope, and love. We talk a lot about faith. We're pretty good about that. We talk a lot about love. But hope is encouragement. Hope is this, is that tomorrow is going to be better than today. That we're giving hope tonight to our businesses, to our community. But more than that, there's families behind every one of those businesses. There's children and there's in those families that are behind these businesses. And we're giving encouragement tonight. We're giving hope.
Okay, so then I agree with you, Pastor. So here's an encouragement to us to make sure that we keep working towards the full encouragement we want to do tonight. So far, to this point this evening, we raised $39,000 for businesses. $39,000. Absolutely, we're just getting started. Now, we've noticed a couple things are happening. Number one, your phones think that they're smarter than you. I'm here to tell you that they are not. Some folks are trying to text through to get the link where they can hop on Secure Giving. And apparently when you type in LLCV, a lot of phones have been auto-correcting that to LLC. So our software center has got a lot of blank texts right now, okay? And you're probably getting discouraged. Wait a second, do they not know what they're doing? We do, and we know so well that we're gonna encourage you to try that one more time. You're gonna start a text message to the number 94000. And in the body of the text, only type LLCV. And if your phone wants to be the boss of you and change that to LLC, rebuke it, get the spirit of the enemy out of autocorrect, and say, no fool, I'm trying to love my valley. So LLCV, if you can get those four letters to us, we're going to get a link right to your phone to set up a very secure, easy giving process.
You guys can check out,
and I know we can get past $39,000
well,
because we need some encouragement this year. One of the things that we want to point your attention to is you can actually hop on the website. Tonight is about raising funds, but we also want to advocate for our local businesses. Pastor, how long have you been here in the Valley?
I've been here 53 years.
53 years in
tonight
the Valley.
Is, I think, the most blessed, single, most important evening that I've ever been in this Valley to experience the kingdom of God and all of these churches moving out from the inside to the outside.
Amen, amen. So you've been here, you've seen a lot of change. Have you ever seen a year for this Valley like the year that we've been through?
You know, I think we want to define our lives by 2020. I think we need to redefine our lives by 2021, what God is going to do in this year.
Yes.
And starting tonight, I really believe this, that God's spirit is moving.
Yeah.
It's going to start by us giving from the inside and giving outside. Thank you for putting this night together.
Yeah, absolutely. And so as I sat off to the side here physically, I realized that I wasn't hopping in on this, and so I made sure I got the right text message through. I got my link back, and my family hopped in and participated. I'll remind you, tonight is the night, y'all, because tomorrow, because our church is stepping in the gap and making sure that we're doing all the accounting and then dispersing it to the 15 churches, tomorrow we're going to start receiving giving for just our church. And if you're here tonight, that's not what you want to give to. We don't want your dollars going there. We want to advance the name of Jesus through what's happening right now. So give tonight. If this is your passion, you can give in person. You can give online until midnight, or you can give us a phone call at 760 760-200-2021. 760-200-2021. Pastor, thank you for being here in this valley for the cause of Christ. Thank you for being here tonight for this event. And as you step off the stage, I'd like to bring up Amy, one of our local small business owners, to the stage. Can you please bring up one of our small business heroes? Amy, you are not wild about speaking in front of crowds, so I'm not going to ask them to yell or hoot or holler or any of that. We're just talking tonight, you and me, okay? It's been quite the year for businesses, but you actually have a story that even led you to start your business before the difficulty of 2020. Tell us the backstory. First of all, give us the name of your business.
Revitalized Juice Bar in India on the Citrus Plaza.
Yep. Okay. Revitalized Juice Bar. We can all find that on our Google Maps and it'll get us right there. But why did you get your business up and running?
Oh, about 2.5 years ago, I was diagnosed with a sarcoma cancer. And obviously, it's devastating. And I had a major surgery and I was told, you're going to die. You don't do this horrible treatment. I did start the treatment, and I shortly stopped the treatment, and I did not believe the doctor. That's why I'm still here today. And lying in bed, it took quite a while for me to recover. I want to start a business. I want to do something that's positive, that gives back to people, that helps me keep healthy, helps other people be healthy, and when I was strong enough, a space became open, and I'm going to start a business. People said, you shouldn't do that. One, it's a pandemic. Two, what if the cancer comes back? What are you going to do? I'm a single mom. You know, when you open a business, you use everything you got.
Yep.
So I was advised not to, but I did it anyways. So I signed a lease in last summer. I didn't think the pandemic would last as long as it did. And we opened in December.
Wow. Yes. So for you, what would assistance, encouragement, or even advocacy for people to know that you guys are open? What does that mean?
You know, it takes a community to make a business, and it takes a business to make a community. Yes. With that, I mean, it goes hand in hand.
Yeah. Very well said. And so for us tonight, you're reminding us of two crucial things. One, the community can embrace this. And I will admit, just like all of us, when the quarantine first hit, the Amazon boxes started to arrive. And somewhere along the line, I thought to myself, I can't just keep clicking my way through my anxiety, and I can't keep spending my money out of this valley. And so what we decided, yeah, absolutely, is not just to raise funds, but to raise awareness and advocacy. Because the second thing you reminded us is that you pass through your own story. There's a person behind the business, and there's kids behind your business, and there's a life behind your business. And so, Amy, on behalf of this crowd, thank you for doing what you're doing. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to remind you guys, you've got to give tonight. It's got to be in this moment, y'all. We've got 3 or 4 different ways. You can hop on our website, lovelocalcv.com. You can see all of the businesses who are participating. You can text your that LLCV, make sure you get it right, all the way to 94000, or you can give us a call, okay? Physical gifts are going to be received here on campus. Checks made to Southwest Church. Guys, $39,000 is great. I ain't gonna lie though, I really wanna get up and give you guys an update that we've hit our goal of $100,000. I realized over here on the side that I hadn't hopped in yet and hadn't participated. I got that checked off my list. Hopefully you're gonna get it checked off your list as well. I would like to introduce to you on our stage right behind me, one of my favorite humans in the world, Pastor Enrique Cuevas.
Buenas noches, ¿cómo están? Hey, I knew the valley spoke Spanish, amen. Why don't you join me in prayer? Let's close our eyes. Let's give God thanks for this beautiful, beautiful night of worship. Father, I pray tonight, Father, that all the glory and all the honor would go to you, Father. In everything we're doing, in every dollar that we're raising. Father, I pray for small businesses, for the employers. Father, that they will also bring honor and glory to you through their business. Father, I pray and I give you thanks, Father, for the entrepreneurial spirit that you have put in them. Señor, te doy gracias por la vida de cada persona, Señor, que tiene un negocio. Por cada persona que ha abierto un negocio, que ha puesto sus esperanzas, su futuro, Señor, en tus manos. Padre, bendícelos y que ellos puedan honrarte, Señor, en todo lo que hacen. In their success, that they give you glory. In their hardships, that they also would give you glory. Padre, te pido también, Señor, que cada negocio, que cada empleador, Señor, pueda servir a esta comunidad y a esta gente en esta comunidad con fidelidad y con bien, Señor. That they would also serve you well, God. That they would serve this community well, all their clients, all the people that come through their businesses. Father, that they would show us how to be Jesus followers in our work, in our business, in the way we handle our finances, in our ethics, Father. Que ellos nos puedan enseñar cómo ser seguidores de Jesús, Señor, a través de cada negocio. Y hoy, Padre Santo, especialmente también, Señor, te doy gracias por cada persona que es empleada, Señor, a través de estos negocios pequeños. Father, and tonight, especially I pray, Father, with my heart for every employee, God, that is employed through all of these small businesses that we're praying for here tonight. Father, that you would keep them safe, God, that you would continue to provide for them and their families through these small businesses. And Father, for the employers to treat them fairly and kindly, Father. Señor, pido que cada empleador trate con dignidad, Señor, a cada uno de sus empleados, Señor. Que sean buenos con ellos, que los animen. Padre, que sean buenos con sus familias también, Señor. Protégelos de todo mal, Señor, a cada empleado de cada empresa que está aquí representada, Señor. Father, we praise you and we give you all the glory for what you're doing tonight. En el nombre de Jesús, amén y amén. Dios les bendiga.
You guys want to donate tonight? 94-000-LLCB.
Give ourselves, Lord, to you. nothing better, Lord, than to be your presence. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, church. Sing with us. Like a rock.
Broken, raise them to glory. Thank you.
me make sure that you are turned on here and we are ready to rock and roll. We are having an absolutely wonderful time. Thank you for being here. Those of you who are online, thank you for giving. Those who are here in person, thank you for giving. If you'd like to give physically during this section where we get to meet another one of the churches and we'll meet another one of our businesses, just raise your hand and we'll get the buckets over to you as carefully and safely as we can. But here from Coachella Valley Christian Church, we've got Pastor Stephen Sloat. Can you please give him a round of applause? Pastor, we've heard from a couple businesses and we've heard from a couple pastors. And a couple pastors we heard from even longer than we anticipated hearing from them.
Really?
Yeah. It's that fine line tonight where we want to lead our valley out of this. And I loved what Pastor Chris said. We shouldn't define ourselves by how we acted in 2020. Let's define ourselves by how we react in 2021. But Jesus talked a lot about leading as a servant. There have been other times where God's people were embedded themselves amongst people who were not God's people. How can we lead like servants through this season, Pastor?
Well, you know, our world thinks of leaders as authority. Jesus said it differently. They were servants. The world defines the greater the leader, the more people there are that serve that leader. In God's economy, the greater the leader, the more people that leader serves. And so we want to be servant leaders. One of the ways, let me share with you what Jesus said about that. In Matthew 20, the disciples were kind of discussing who was greater, who should be more, who was more important, who's the one to be in charge. And Jesus called them to himself and said, "You know the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great men exercise authority over them. It is not this way among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you shall be your servant. And whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your slave. Just as the Son of Man, Jesus, did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." One of the ways we can serve is taught by Jeremiah, writing to God's people who are waiting for God to bring them back home, waiting for him to lead them out of the trouble they were in. And Jeremiah wrote and said, "Seek the welfare of the city where I have sent you into exile, and pray to the Lord on its behalf, for in its welfare you will have welfare." We can serve as leaders by seeking the welfare of where we live. That's what this is all about.
Amen.
Love locals about this. And second part is by praying for that city, that community.
Yeah. So I want to brag to you about them. The first passage you read even talked about the Son of Man giving himself as a ransom for many. Our goal tonight was to give $100,000. And I'm starting to get worried that that's not what we're going to do, because we're already at $95,362. That we're not going to hit the goal of $100,000, but that we're going to leave the goal in our rearview mirror and give past it. And so if you are watching online, hop online to give or text or call in. And I want you guys who are here in person, if you're encouraged and challenged to give in person, you raise a hand, we'll bring a bucket to you. You can leave tonight by visiting one of our giving towers. Tower is such a generous term. It's a box on wheels, y'all. I am so doggone proud to be a part of a valley of faith who are embedded amongst people who are not God's people, but we are compelling them to his goodness through our willingness to lead from the position of a servant's heart. Doggone it. Okay. Now, with that said, I'd love to bring up one last business tonight. New Leaf Catering. Where are you at? Can you please join us as she joins us? Gaynor is going to join us on stage tonight. Pastor, you can even maybe give her a hand and help her up. We are excited to have you. We're going to notice right off the bat. First of all, go ahead and introduce yourself and then what business you represent.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Gaynor Richter, and I run New Leaf Catering.
Yes, you do. But we all picked up on in the first moments of our time with you, you're not originally from around here, are you?
No, I'm true blue South African.
That is so cool. By the way, I'm sorry this isn't even on the cue card, but I'm going to just get this in. Don't forget, church, that when you impact the Coachella Valley, you impact the world because of how many people come to visit here. And if we make an impact on this valley, all the people coming in and out of this valley carry it back to their world. There's some New Testament in there, but we're going to keep moving. Your business is New Leaf Catering.
Yes, sir.
Yes, and you guys cater events. And that's probably a significant portion of the business that you bring in. Events have not been a thing for a minute here. That's been rough. How has the pandemic been a challenge on your business?
What actually happened? Do you believe in divine appointments?
I happen to, yes.
I think tonight is a divine appointment.
I think so as well.
We got a call one day from a lady in your community saying, would you partner with us? We wanting to take care of our first responders. And immediately it was like, I'm not even going to think about that. Of course we're going to do that. What had happened was when everything started shutting down, our business closed for 3 weeks. Only. We have been fully operational the whole pandemic. It has been truly remarkable to see the hand of God. When you partner, you know, at 16, I know we're going off cue here, you don't mind. All the ladies go, yeah. At 16, you know, Apostle Paul was busy on his journey. He's doing a little walkabout and he prays. And in the night, he has a vision of this man calling to him, say, come, you know, come on over. Anyway, he's moving around and he goes from town to town and, you know, the story. And he ends up going to the river, looking for a place of prayer. And who is there? There's a Lydia, a seller of purple linen. There are Lydias among us tonight. There are captains of industry among us tonight. And I believe that there are divine appointments where God said, I will connect you with the church and with business, and I'll put you together to reach the community. And that's what Southwest did with us.
Amen. So let me say back to you my side of that story. First of all, I've stood in the spot where Lydia was baptized in this world. Oh. And it gives me chills to hear you talk about her tonight. Because our church held an event similar to this many months back. And one of the targets of that event was to bless local healthcare providers and first responders. And so this church gave to that, and we're ready to move that money. And you are one of the businesses that we called, and we said, hey, we'd like to spend our money on healthcare workers. And you said, why don't you guys partner with us to do that? And we're mobilizing business. And guys, I'm telling you, that's the example that we can set again tonight as these churches, 15 churches now split equally amongst us, what God's people have done, and 15 churches now move out to businesses like New Leaf Catering, and 15 churches make an impact through business on business. I'm telling you, it's exponential. And I'm just getting beeping in my ear. Do you know what our total is now? $99,500. We are thrilled to have partnered with you and your business to advance the Here's goodness of God right into there, this guys. Valley already. And I'm telling you right now, we want to keep doing more. And one of the ways that you can do this is if you know a business and you're thinking, oh man, I wish, you know, God bless New Leaf Catering, but I wish so-and-so knew. I wish my chiropractor knew. I wish our little coffee shop knew. Then get the word out. You take to them tomorrow the website, and they can hop on and you could submit them. We want more advocacy. We want more awareness. We want less Amazon boxes and more New Leaf Catering. We want less Amazon boxes and we want more Revitalized Juice Bar. We want less Amazon and more Coachella Valley, because when we're advocating for it, it's more gospel. Amen. Amen. So with that said, we're going to have one more pastor pray. And we are going to have one more update for you at the end of this prayer. So Pastor Israel Orellana from Fuente de Vida
Man, Enrique is not the only one. Quien habla español, yo también, pero pastor, vamos a orar.
Mira nomás, si habla español también. Praise God. Praise God that we're all coming together. We're united in Jesus. It's Jesus who brings us together. And it's Jesus who we're lifting up. It's Jesus who we're making famous. The church is coming together. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world if he loses his soul? It doesn't matter if we save every business in the Coachella Valley if they lose their soul. Every miracle Jesus did wasn't just to better the life of that person. It was to point them to the Father, to a relationship with God. That's what we're doing. We're using our dollars, the money that's coming together. The churches that receive it are using it to care for the needy ones in the community. And they're intentionally spending those dollars with local businesses. So know that none of the funds are staying here or at any other church. They're going to help those in need through by way of churches, by way of businesses that are locally owned and operated. God is so good. That someone said something about a old school offering, but they didn't have any old school music. But I'm gonna get in trouble. But would you be free from your burden of sin? Hay poder en Jesús. I ain't gonna sing or they won't invite me back. But let's give honor and glory to God. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for this day. God, we thank you that you are so good. We thank you that each person sitting in these chairs, you have sustained them. Thank you, God, that you've helped us through. Thank you, God, that you've never left us, nor have you forsaken us. Gracias, Señor, que estás con nosotros. Nunca nos has dejado, nunca nos has desamparado, y nunca lo harás. You will never leave us or forsake us. You are with us. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, that you're intentionally using the church to show their communities that you love them, that they need Jesus Christ in their life, that without Jesus, no gain, nothing we can obtain is of value. God, we worship you. I pray that you would move in the hearts and lives of your people and that we could be walking, living testimonies of God's love and his grace, that every person in the Coachella Valley, that every business owner in this Coachella Valley would know that you love them, would know that there's a church that cares about them. We bless your name. We praise you, Jesus, the mighty name of Jesus. Everyone give a hand clap to the Lord.
All right. If Miss Jennifer Shaw is here with us this evening, if she could join me on stage for one last moment. If Jennifer Shaw is with us, she is wonderful from St. John's Lutheran. Can you please welcome Jennifer to the stage? Jennifer, I've got one simple question for you. As we close our time together, we're going to kick it from you back to Pastor Ricky in a moment. It is unconventional for a group of churches to get together and say, hey, you know what? Let's give money to business. But this year and this valley, we need it. What would you say to anybody tonight watching online or here in person? What would you say to them if they gave?
Such a wonderful question.
Thank you.
Thank you. I would say thank you. I would say we are called to serve our Lord Jesus Christ, not only in word, but in truth and in deed. And in giving, we are doing what the early church did. This was a group of people who were living differently than the world around them. And they were taking care of each other, and they were seeking the good of the city and the good of others. And when people said, why are you doing this? They said, we are doing this in the name of Jesus Christ. And they lifted him up. And I am so grateful to be part of the churches that are here with all of you. So I would say thank you for lifting up the name of Jesus Christ in word and deed.
Amen. I'm not sure I could have said it any better, so I will say no more. But I do got a friend, and he would like to let you guys know a couple of things, including a final tally for tonight. If you are watching at home, or if you're here at the event and you're worried that it's closing and you haven't given yet, Giving online is going to go exclusively to this cause until midnight tonight. So if you'd like to leave from here and head home, you can still do that. If you want to do the text option until midnight tonight, I cannot state enough. Our church does not want to receive a dollar that your heart wants to go towards this. And so please, 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 if you'd like to give to this initiative, it's got to happen tonight, okay? Because tomorrow, all of our churches are going to continue our normal operations, but we don't want any of your gift to this valley to go to our church. We want it all to go to the churches participating in the valley at large. So by midnight tonight, giving is staying open online till midnight, texting as well. And if you'd like to call in, we're going to be here for a little bit longer. I'm not going to give any more definition than that. But with that said, is my friend ready to come up on stage? Can somebody hand Pastor Ricky Jenkins a microphone? Ladies and gentlemen, as we get ready to close out this night, man, there ain't no way we didn't hit it, right? Ricky, I need to know. Let us know.
Give it up for Pastor Tim Cool. All of our brother and sister pastors here in the valley that were here tonight. We're going to sing one more song and let you go tonight. I can see nothing. Y'all still there? Okay, I can't see. Can y'all see me? Okay, all right. We're going to have one more song of celebration. Isn't Jesus good to bring his sons and daughters together under the beautiful sky? Isn't he good? Isn't he good? He's just worthy. So about a year ago, all of us were scared to death, wondering what was going on with the world. And every pastor in this valley just started digging deep and loving on their people. And you guys were faithful. You didn't give up on God. And we got through it. And we're going to be all right, and we're going to be better because of it. And about May, June or something last year, Southwest decided to raise $1 million to give away to Coachella Valley Rescue Mission. We took care of our law enforcement officers. And in one night, Jesus said, "I still own the cattle on 1,000 hills. And he did it. And we blessed people, and it was great. And Pastor Brad Kinney, he's a guy on our team. He's a prayer walker. So if you ever come to Southwest and there's a crazy man sweating and like doing the Olympic walk, like he's kind of, you know, like he's praying around this campus, that's Pastor Brad Kinney. And after we did that, he came to me and says, "Man, I believe Jesus wants us to bring all the churches together to worship and do something great for this city." And because Jesus spoke to him, and because of his obedience and faithfulness, 1 year later, we're all here tonight. Well done, good and faithful servant. We love you. We're going to go, but let's kind of give some hoop and hollering where hoop and hollering is due, and we're just going to sing some stuff here. But give it up. I don't know about y'all, but I feel a Coachella Valley Church album in my spirit. Can I get a witness out there? Would you buy that CD? Oh, I'm sorry. Would you stream that online? Give it up for the baddest worship team in all the land. Give it up for all of the churches and volunteers and security and staff folk that made all this happen. Give it up to them. Now give it up for all of the small businesses of the Coachella Valley. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for $106,000, small businesses. We thank you, Love Logo. Hallelujah. Hey, let's stand on our feet. Hold out your hands like this to receive a blessing, but don't leave because we're going to party after that. Listen, Coachella Valley, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon each and every one of you and bring you peace. We pray this in the name of the Father, and of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. And if you're never going to stop praising Him, start clapping your hands. If you're never going to stop serving Him, clap your hands. If you're never going to stop loving Him, clap your hands. If you're never going to stop believing Him, clap your hands. If you're never going to stop trusting Him, clap your hands. And choir, if you're never going to stop singing, let's sing to the Lord. Let's go.
Never gonna stop singing. All right, now we're gonna.
LoveLocalCV.com to give. We've reached our mind over 100,000.